Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to be considering the four quadrants. This is a continuation of the series of problems we worked on circles and trigonometry. To see one of them, just click on the link at the top right hand corner of your screen. Okay, so here is it. A quadrant is a quarter of a circle. So, and we know a circle to be the locus of points that is equidistant from a fixed point. So we've got infinite number of points on the boundary, and this point here is the center of the circle. Now, if I partition this circle into four equal parts, like this, now each portion would be a quadrant. Basically, a shape like this is called a quadrant. It's a quarter of a circle. Okay, so why is this so special to warrant our attention? It's very, very crucial because we can say lots of things about it. Now, the quadrant also moves in a particular manner, and that's a counterclockwise direction. So the quadrant moves in a counterclockwise direction like this. And this is the first quadrant. It moves in a counterclockwise direction from right to left at the top of the circle. The second part is the second quadrant. The third one here at the bottom, so here is the third quadrant, and finally this is the fourth quadrant. Now we know from basic math that the sum of angles at the point is 360 degrees, so this point right here, all of the angles that over around it sum up to 360 degrees, and since a quadrant is a quarter of a circle, so we can tell that the angle in each quadrant is 90 degrees. And since this is the first quadrant, so the angle here is going to range, the angle in the first quadrant is going to range between 0 and 90 degrees. The second quadrant is going to range between 90 and 180 degrees. That's an additional 90. In the third quadrant, that's 180 plus an additional 90. That's going to be 270 degrees. And in the fourth quadrant, we've got angles between 270 and 360 degrees. Now, we can tell from the first quadrant, we worked on trigonometry in our previous videos, and I made mention of the three basic trig functions. Those are the sine of angles, sine theta, the cosine, that's cos theta, and the tangent, that's tan theta. So in the first quadrant, all of this is positive. So what this tells us is that if my intention is to obtain the sine, the cosine, or the tan of an angle between 0 and 90 degrees, I'm always going to get a positive number. For example, sine of 10 is going to give me a positive number. Cosine of 10 is going to give a positive number. Tangent of 10 is also going to give a positive number. So any number between the range of 0 and 90 degrees, its sine, cos, and tan would give positive values, because in the first quadrant, all the three trigonometrical ratios are positive. Okay, so let's move on to the second quadrant. The range of values of theta is between 90 degrees and 180 degrees. Now, the only trig function that is positive here in the second quadrant is the sine. So in the second quadrant, only sine is positive, cosine and tangents are negative. So for example, The sine of 120 is going to give a positive number, but the cosine and tan of 120 will give negative values. Now, a relationship exists between the angles in the second and first quadrants, also in the angles in the third and first, and finally in the angles in the fourth and the first quadrants. Let's start with the angles in the second quadrant. Now, if theta 2 is the angle in the second quadrant, it relates with the angles in the first quadrant by this formula. Theta 1 equals 180, of course, in degrees, minus theta 2. This is the connection between the angles in the first and second quadrant. What do I mean by this? For example, let's give an angle in the second quadrant, just any arbitrary angle. Let's pick 150. So if theta 2 is 150, I can find its equivalent in the first quadrant by using this formula. So therefore, my theta 1 is going to be 180 degrees minus theta 2, that's 150. So this tells us that theta 1 is equal to 30 degrees. So what 150 degrees is in the second quadrant is what 30 degrees is in the first quadrant. Now, this is where it gets very interesting. From one of our previous videos, we discussed the special angles where we figured out that sine 30 degrees is 1/2, which is of course 0.5. Now, if I want to obtain the value of sine 150 degrees, first, 150 degrees is an angle that's between 90 and 180 degrees, so it falls in the second quadrant. And I know that in the second quadrant, sine is still positive. So this is going to be positive sine. Now, 150 has an equivalent in the first quadrant, going by this formula. And that's 180 minus 150, that's 30 degrees. So this tells us that sine 150 is the same as positive sine 30 degrees. Of course, this is going to be plus 1/2. Okay, so we can extend the same arguments to cosine. So the cosine of 150 degrees, I'm going to use the same argument. Now, since 150 is in the second quadrant, I know that cosine is negative. So this is going to be negative cosine. So 150 in the second quadrant corresponds to 30 degrees in the first, so this is going to be 30 degrees. So it implies that cos 150 degrees is equivalent to negative cos 30 degrees. And from our last video, this is cos 30 degrees is root 3 over 2. So this is just going to be negative root 3 over 2. Tan of 150 degrees is also going to be negative tan 30 degrees, because in the second quadrant tan is also negative, so this is going to be negative 1 over root 3. So this is the application of the formula connecting the first and the second quadrants. Next is to consider the third quadrant. In the third quadrant, of course, we know that the angle is between 180 and 270 degrees. So we've got 180 degrees less than theta, less than 270 degrees. Now, in the third quadrant, only the tangent is positive, the sine and the cosine are both negative. And like as we have in the second quadrant, there is also a formula connecting the third quadrant and the first. The formula is theta 3 is equal to 180 plus theta 1. It's a bit different from the second one. Now, how does this formula work? Let's pick an arbitrary angle between 180 and 270 degrees. I'm going to go for 240 degrees. Okay, so if theta 3 is equal to 240 degrees. Now, this is how the formula works. Theta 3 equals 180 plus theta 1 would require us to obtain the angle that needs to be added to 180 to get 240 degrees. So I've got theta 3, 240 degrees equals 180 plus, of course, the angle is going to be 60 degrees. So what this tells us is that theta 3, which is 240, corresponds with theta 1, which is 60 degrees. Okay, so let's do one or two things on sine, cosine, and tan. Now, the sine of 240 degrees is going to be equal to negative sine, because in the third quadrant, sine is negative. And of course, 240 corresponds with 60 degrees. So that's going to be negative sine 60 degrees. Similarly, the cosine of 240 degrees is going to be negative cos 60 degrees. The negative comes from the sine, of course, in this third quadrant. And the 60 degrees comes from the equivalent of 240 degrees in the first quadrant. And finally, tan 240 degrees is going to be equal to positive tan, because in the third quadrant, the tangent is positive. So this is going to be positive tan 60 degrees. So, and of course, we know what sine 60 degrees is. Sine 60 degrees with 3 over 2. So it means sine 240 degrees is going to be negative with 3 over 2. Negative with 3 over 2. So we know what cos 60 is. That's 1 half. So it means cos 240 is going to be negative 1 half. And of course, we know what tan 60 degrees is. That's root, the square root of 3. Okay, so finally, we are going to move to the fourth quadrant. In the fourth quadrant, we've got angles between 270 degrees and 360 degrees. So we have 270 degrees less than theta, less than 360 degrees. So in the fourth quadrant, only the cosine is positive. Both the sine and the tangent are negative. And of course, as usual, there is a formula connecting the fourth and the first quadrants. Here is the formula. Theta 1 equals 360 minus theta 4. So this formula here looks very much like the formula in the second quadrant. The only complicated one here is the one in the third quadrant. And with practice, I'm sure you are going to get it. Now let's pick an arbitrary angle in the fourth quadrant. I'm going to go with 315. So if theta 4 is equal to 315 degrees, so what that tells us is that its value, its equivalent in the first quadrant is going to be 360 minus 315, and this is 45 degrees. Okay, so what's going to be the value of sine 315 degrees? Of course, since sine is negative in the fourth quadrant, I'm going to have negative sine. And the value of 315 is 45 degrees, because it's 360 minus 315. So this is negative sine 45. So sine 315 is going to have the same value as sine 45. The only difference is that it's going to be a negative. Similarly, cos 315 is going to give positive cos 45 degrees, and tan 315 is going to give negative tan 45 degrees. Taking all of this together, we would see that if this is a quadrant of a circle, if each one is a quadrant of a circle, we can develop an acronym here, A, S, T, C. Some will call it all students take coffee. That's if they are moving in a counterclockwise manner, the direction of the quadrants. All students take coffee to represent all of the three trig functions, the sine, the tan, and the cos across the four quadrants. Or some people will call it acts. So this is moving in the clockwise manner, and this can be confusing. I do not encourage students to use act because they might confuse it, because the direction here is clockwise and the quadrant moves in a counterclockwise direction. This is counterclockwise and this is clockwise. So this is the one I encourage. If you find this video useful, kindly like, share, drop a comment, and do not forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.